Hello, this is a video on propositions and truth tables. And if you need this worksheet, you can get it on my website at caraleemath.com. And before we get into these truth tables, I want to give you an example to show you the big picture of what we're doing here. I have a ballot measure from fall of 2016, measure 97. You might remember this, you may have even voted on it. Ballot measure 97 was to increase the corporate minimum tax for corporations with at least $25 million in Oregon sales. And it was defeated 59% to 41%. This is just the explanation of it. It says that revenues generated are to be used to provide additional funding for education, healthcare, and services for senior citizens. So this was a very controversial ballot measure, and in the voter's guide there were plenty of arguments for and against. So I have one of the arguments in opposition, and you don't need to write this down. I just want to give you the reasoning for why we're doing this. This is from some school board members, said we oppose Measure 97 because it damages our economy and hurts low and middle income families without guaranteeing a single extra teacher or school day. So these are all propositions. These are all statements that they're making to support an argument. It would reduce household income and cost families hundreds of dollars per year. Then I also have an argument in favor. Oregon has faced a consistent revenue shortage, resulting in fewer opportunities and protections for Oregon students and vulnerable populations. While Oregon's economy and populations have grown, limitations on the state's ability to raise revenue have prevented adequate funding of schools and critical services. So it's really important to be able to break down these arguments, understand what they're saying, and then make our own informed decision. So we will be analyzing these more complex arguments. They can get really complicated when putting all these statements together. So what we're going to do first is take the building blocks and start with very simple statements called propositions. And so for this video, we have two example propositions, and we use lowercase letters to represent propositions. So we have P and Q. P is Jamie is wearing jeans, and Q is Jamie is wearing a hat. So you see, we're just going down to the very basic building blocks of arguments, a single statement, and it has to be a complete sentence. It could be true or false, but it's just a statement. We have our jeans and hat over here to help us out and visualize things, and the hat's a little too big for the jeans maybe, but oh well. Okay, so we're going to, once we have our propositions, then people put those together into larger statements using negation, like not, and, or, and if then. So we're gonna analyze all of these today in truth tables. Now this is what a truth table looks like. It's a table and it has a column for the proposition and then whatever connectors you're using to put them together. So for negation and double negation, we're just using a single one, P. So I'll get rid of the hat for right now because we're just using P, which is Jamie's wearing jeans. And the first thing we want to do is put all of the possibilities in for P. Now the only possible options for P are true or false. Jamie's wearing jeans or not, there's no in between here. Okay, so if Jamie's wearing jeans, P, if that's true, then not P would be the statement Jamie is not wearing jeans. Well, we know Jamie's wearing jeans, so that would be false. And not P is the double negative or double negation. So that would be Jamie is not wearing jeans. So if Jamie's true, if Jamie is wearing jeans, if that's true, then Jamie is not wearing jeans. That is also true. So you can think of it as the not statement is always the opposite of the original, and not is the double negative that goes back to the original. If you say, I ain't got no money, You're really saying you have money. That's a double negative. The second row is false. So now Jamie is not wearing jeans. So not P would be Jamie is not wearing jeans. That is true. It's the opposite of the original statement. And then not P, Jamie is not wearing jeans. That is false. Because Jamie is not wearing jeans. So again, the not P is opposite of P, and not P goes back to the original. You see examples of these double negatives. I have another example. This is from House Bill 2007, trying to get more affordable housing in the city. And here's one example. This prohibits city or county from prohibiting. So it's prohibiting them from prohibiting. That's a double negative. There's another one, prohibits local governments from discouraging. So another double negative. You see those a lot, and sometimes you'll see triple or quadruple negatives, and it can be really confusing, and then you're trying to figure out which way to vote. So that's why negation and double negation are really important. Okay, let's go to the and statement. Now we're going to combine two of these. So we see how we have two columns, one for P and one for Q. The first thing we want to do is just list all the possible combinations. So for P, we will take the first half of the rows and make them true, and the second half, make them false. And then in Q, we can alternate true, false, true, false. What that does, it gives us all the possible combinations. It's ideal to set up your table this way, because then yours will match mine, yours will match your other group members, and you won't be confused about, oh, my row one is your row three, and so forth. So always set up your truth table like that. Now we're combining these two statements or two propositions with an and. So we're making a larger statement. So we're going to do each row individually. In the first row, P is true and Q is true. So it says P is true, so Jamie is wearing jeans. And Q is true, so Jamie is wearing a hat. So P and Q would be Jamie is wearing jeans and a hat. Is that true? Yes, that's true. Jamie is wearing both. So they are wearing jeans and a hat. In the second row, Jamie's wearing jeans is true, but Jamie's wearing a hat is false. So is Jamie wearing both jeans and a hat? No, that's false. In the third row, Jamie's wearing jeans is false. So get rid of the jeans, and Jamie's wearing a hat is true. Is Jamie wearing both jeans and a hat? No. And if you want to try these out on your own, feel free to pause the video, try it, and then start it up again. In the last row, we have false and false. So Jamie is not wearing jeans and not wearing a hat. Is Jamie wearing both jeans and a hat? No, that's false. So for our and statement, notice one of them is different. The only way to get a true statement is if both of them are true. Okay, let's look at or. Raise this up a little bit. Get our jeans and hat back. Okay, or statement. So again, we have P and Q because we're going to look at P or Q. And we'll set this up with the first two true. Second, true, false, and then we'll alternate true, false, true, false. All four possibilities. Okay, let's look at them individually. So true or true. Jamie's wearing jeans is true. Jamie's wearing a hat is true. So is Jamie wearing jeans or a hat? Yes. They're wearing both. So this is called an inclusive or, because Jamie's wearing jeans or a hat or both. So that's an inclusive or. This is the most common kind of or that we'll be looking at, but there's also an exclusive or, so I'll write that down too. We use the context usually to determine whether it's inclusive or exclusive. An example of exclusive or is when you're ordering a dinner and they ask if you want soup or salad. Now, are they saying, do you want soup or salad or both? No, they're just asking if you want soup or salad. You would have to pay extra usually to get both. So that is called an exclusive or. Both is excluded. In this case, is Jamie wearing jeans or a hat? Yes, they're wearing both, but it's still true. Okay, let's look at the next line. So in this line, Jamie is wearing jeans, but not wearing a hat because Q is false. Is Jamie wearing jeans or a hat? Yes, they're wearing jeans. In the third row, Jamie is not wearing jeans, but is wearing a hat. So is Jamie wearing jeans or a hat? Yes, they're wearing a hat. Or is different, right? They just have to be wearing one or the other, or both. The last line, they're both false. So Jamie is not wearing jeans and not wearing a hat. So the statement, Jamie is wearing jeans or a hat, is false because they're wearing neither. This is the one that's different. They're all true except it's false if both are false. Now you don't have to memorize that. You just want to think through every situation and determine for yourself. And it helps to have a visual, so you can always make one for yourself. All right, one more to go, and that's the if then or conditional statement. If then is when you put two things together. So we're going to look at if P, then Q. So that statement would look like this. If I wear jeans, then I will wear a hat. So let's say Jamie said this to their friends. If I wear jeans tomorrow, then I'll wear a hat. Okay, could happen, right? Let's start with our true, false. Okay, so Jamie says, if I wear jeans, then I'll wear a hat. And P is true, so they are wearing jeans. And Q is true, so they are wearing a hat. So if Jamie wears jeans, then they'll wear a hat. That's true, because they're wearing jeans and a hat. In the second line, Jamie's wearing jeans, but not a hat. So Jamie said, if I wear jeans, then I'll wear a hat. Is that true? Did they tell the truth? No, because they wore jeans, but not the hat. So the if part has to be, if that's true, then the then part has to be true. So that is false. Okay, here's the third line. P is false. So Jamie is not wearing jeans, but is wearing a hat. Now this one is interesting. Jamie said, if I wear jeans, then I'll wear a hat. But Jamie's not wearing jeans. They didn't say anything about what happens if they're not wearing jeans. So we actually call this true. Might seem a little bit unusual, but you could think of it, has Jamie lied? No. They just said, if they wear jeans, they'll wear a hat. But if they don't wear jeans, we don't know. Doesn't matter if they wear a hat or not. The last one, Jamie's not wearing jeans and also not wearing a hat. So Jamie said, if I wear jeans, then I'll wear a hat. They're wearing neither, so they haven't lied. We call this true. They haven't said anything about what happens if they don't wear jeans. This, you could run into this a lot when someone makes a campaign promise. If I'm elected, I will do this. And if they're not elected, well, they might do it or not. They might not be in the position to, but they're really only making a statement about if they get elected. So if they don't, we would say they haven't told a lie. We get that. That is true. So on this one, one is different, just like the others. The only way to get a false statement in an if then is if the hypothesis, the if part is true, but the conclusion is false. That's the only way this one can be false. So thank you for watching this introduction on propositions and truth tables, and I'll see you in the next video.